I'm leaving now.
Lucy, my sweet.
I cleaned out the tiger cage and sorted all the meal bins. So, if it's all right, it's my turn to fix dinner.
Haven't you forgotten something, little one? Just one little thing?
Mr. Runciter, please.
It's been a very long day.
I don't want to.
Now, Lucy, I thought we'd settled this last week. Don't let's forget who pays your salary. We're closed. Come back tomorrow. Wait, I haven't finished with you. I told you, we're closed.
We're not here to buy, little man. We've come to sell.
You can't possibly have anything to interest me. These are extremely rare animals of the highest quality.
What a coincidence. So am I. That is the price for humility.
Oh, please, don't.
And what else might we interest you in today, sir? Perhaps some virtue?
Not my animals, please. I'm begging you.
But what of honor, little man? At what price? Honor.
Oh, my God, no. That tiger is the rarest specimen ever seen.
Tiger, tiger, burning bright. The forest of the night.
BR-61661, report to precinct headquarters. Code 3, repeat code 3.
I was just finishing up my 12 out on patrol when I got the call. Welcome relief, considering that the most action I'd seen all night was a schizoid grandmother doing the shimmy in her underwear in the second sector. Last time I had a 3 was when some hooker vomited Thunderbird on Bryant's desk, and yours truly led the cleanup crew. Year and a half on the job, it was still the dirtiest work I'd seen. Where's Captain Bryant?
Took a sick day. Got himself a heinous case of ptomaine poisoning. He asked me personally to run the unit in his absence.
Guza was one of the old-time guys who took their knocks in the streets. He had a friendly way about him, but you didn't want to turn your back on him if you were less than a friend.
Hope you've been enjoying your leisure time, kid, because it's time to take that thumb out of your ass.
Hallelujah.
Don't get too excited. The other Blade Runners are all jammed up. Holden's sucking dinner through a straw. Gaff's working the Tyrell break-in and Steele's working special undercover. Looks like you got this one by default.
You really know how to make a girl feel wanted.
Animal murder done at Runciter Zoological. Probably just be a schizoid glitz, but we got the call. Old man Runciter lost something like a billion chinions worth.
10 to 1, this ain't a job for Rep Detect.
You got something better to do? Perfect your French cooking, maybe?
Slumming tonight, Slim?
I thought you were on special assignment.
Wasn't too damn special after I had the suckers out.
What happened?
A couple of fours were masquerading as fibroblast insulators down at Kaiser. I dressed up like a nurse, they never had a chance.
I'll bet. You put them on the machine?
Hell no! There's a beautiful little thing in here called the magic, and it ain't ever been wrong. You develop it, you got a brilliant career ahead of you.
I'm working on it.
What's Guza got you doing tonight?
AM at Runciter's.
Animal murder. Oh, those skin jobs got no respect for anything that truly lives and breathes. And that goddamn Eldon Tyrell ought to be zipped into a body bag and flushed into deep space.
Get rid of him, we'd be out of a job.
I think we're all overdue for a little off-world paid vacation. You can stop staring at my ass now.
You got eyes in the back of your head?
All you gotta do is ask, Slim.
Animal sales was a profitable and prestigious business since most real animals had died out after the Terran War. There were plenty of electric ones, though, powered by rechargeable batteries. No self-respecting human would own one of those frauds.
Find something? Piece of chrome. From a car?
No, I think it's horse chrome. Bag it and tag it. What do you know?
About 30 counts of animal murder and one of aggravated assault. The shop's been thrashed. You ought to see this tiger cub they got in there. It's a goddamn tragedy.
How's old man Runciter holding up?
State of shock. He's been moaning and complaining about his world caving in.
You'd feel the same way if they were your animals. How many perps?
At least 2. Bloody footprints all over the scene.
Must be a delightful sight. Canvass the area. Maybe somebody had his eyes open.
I'm on it.
Scratches and paint flecks, and I knew what they meant. Unless the city had bought a jet black fire truck, somebody had a big fat traffic ticket coming. Nothing even remotely interesting, but hell, if I was going to root through trash, my expectations weren't too high. Judging from the distance between the prints, I was looking for 2 very big men. One dragged his right foot, indicating a possible injury or lameness. The other appeared a lot more controlled, graceful even. Quite a pair.
McCoy, LPD.
I'm absolutely certain Lucy Devlin was involved in this heinous act. She's the young girl who works for me.
She's responsible for all this mayhem?
No, of course not! It was 2 men acting in concert with her, obviously.
Obviously. What'd they look like?
Big and scary and absolutely malevolent.
You got any discs from that camera?
It's irrelevant. Those murderers also destroyed the camera. Thousands of chinyens worth.
Maybe it photographed them before they shot it out.
I guess you've got a point at that. I believe this is the disc from last night.
Peachy.
All my animals.
Can you think of anything they might have been after?
First, I thought they wanted money, but I don't keep any in the shop. Then I thought they wanted to steal my animals, but they started executing them.
Could they have been replicants?
Who else would be capable of such barbaric acts?
It didn't add up. Animal murders, the lack of any theft, the small animals alone were worth a good chunk of change on the street. It seemed more like an act of vengeance. Canvass the area. Maybe somebody had his eyes open.
I'm on it.
You ever do any business with the replicant manufacturers, Tyrell Corporation?
I resent that accusation.
Just wondering.
Officer, last May I personally sold Governor Kolvig an exquisite Percheron colt. I have been a guest at his house on 3 separate occasions. Do I look like I need to carry artificial product?
Tell me about this Lucy.
There's not a lot I can tell you. She's only worked for me for about a month. She's about 14 years old with pink hair. A very attractive young thing.
How'd you find her?
She came to me with a reference from Ogilvy's in the Northwest Zone. And he's a very reputable wholesaler.
You treat her well?
As well as any young tot should be treated.
She got a desk? Or someplace where she worked?
She used to eat over there. My precious one. She was my baby.
A toy dog. Howie Lee's in Chinatown. I'd eaten there myself. A candy bar. Yuck. Well, isn't that cute? See if you can dig up that reference from Ogilvy's.
Yes, it's somewhere here. Just a moment. Here you are.
Stick around. I may not be finished with you. Find anything else out here?
This woman says she saw that kid who worked for Runciter hanging around with a big fat guy last week.
Canvass the area. Maybe somebody had his eyes open.
I'm on it.
Find anything else out here?
This guy lives across the street. Says he heard a crash late last night. Looked out his window and saw a black sedan speeding away from the scene.
Find anything else out here?
Zilcho. Row actions inside. Abstract art. All over the walls and ceiling.
I never did appreciate art.
Laboratory.
Got anything new for me, Dino?
I was wondering when you'd show your mug around here, McCoy. We got the animal corpses from Runciter's, but there wasn't a whole lot to work with.
Bone marrow?
About 50% were real, the rest were fakes.
So, Runciter was ripping his customers off.
State-of-the-art fakes. Miles beyond the crap you see on Animoid Row.
The kind that comes from legit manufacturers?
And they're the ones that usually produce the quality.
What about the wounds?
Most of them were shot point blank, but we're looking at some others. Sloppy cuts with a knife, like the perp was really pissed off at something.
Butcher knife?
Could be, but who cuts meat anymore?
Nice bunch of reps I'm tailing. Hope you're not pulling a meat cleaver out of my back next week. Anything else?
That black paint you found on the fire hydrant? It's from a ground car.
You sure?
The angle of impact was almost head-on. and there ain't too many spinner drivers klutzy enough to smack a street-level hydrant in VTOL mode.
I heard your wife got her license back.
You're a real funny guy, McCoy.
Anything else?
That piece of chrome you found outside of Runciter's is from a 1995 Pontiac.
Nice set of wheels.
It's okay, not what I call a classic.
Anything else?
Zip, man. Dry me later.
Mainframe and shooting range.
Violent street crime in the city rose again last year by a whopping 26%, according to the latest figures from the Department of Justice. Governor Kolvig attributed the change to the dramatic increase in the number of specials registered as city residents and promised a tough new set of standards for the City Immigration Bureau by next month.
Uploading personal clue database. Downloading mainframe clue database. Clue database transfer complete.
Howie Lees in China.
This woman says she saw that kid who worked for Runciter hanging around. This guy lives across
Judge.
Most that
Judge.
She came to me with a reference from Ogilvy's in the Northwest Zone, and he's a...
Scanning video disk. Two enhanceable images found. Adding enhanceable photographs to Kaya database. Runciter crime scene.
A sushi menu from Howie Lee's. Give me a hard copy of that.
Runciter crime scene.
He looks familiar. Give me a hard copy of that. Muddy boots. Guess he's from out of town. Give me a hard copy of that. A black ground car. Looks like it's been around the block a few times. Give me a hard copy of that.
Runciter crime scene.
Muddy boots. Guess he's Howie Lees. Bryant once got...
Uploading personal clue database. Downloading mainframe clue database. Clue database transfer complete.
mainframe, and ground floor. Lockup.
Are they letting me out?
I'm not the one who makes that decision.
I suppose it's my turn to bear the cross for the cause.
Who are you, anyway?
Please leave me alone. My migraine's acting up.
Bryant, go on permanent leave and you get full use of the office, Lieutenant?
You know the procedure. Dump it all in the mainframe upstairs and I'll read it later.
You got it. Sorry to bother you, Lieutenant. I was just checking in.
We'll get back out there. Those reps ain't retiring themselves.
Yeah, suicidal targets would make my job a lot easier.
Everybody's got a job, kid.
Roof.
Real sushi was a luxury reserved only for the elite, since most sea life had become radioactive after the Third Terran War. The rest of us had to eat new sushi, soya mixed with off-world lichen. McCoy, LPD, I want to ask you a couple of questions.
Sorry, my man. I just don't got the time.
Hey, big guy.
Busy! No time for talk!
McCoy, itazura suru na! You want something, you talk to me.
Sorry, Howie.
Got to mix more out back.
Beautiful night, isn't it?
When business thriving, night always beautiful.
This from your place, isn't it?
Could be. Chops that come from Yoshi's restaurant supply.
This from your place, isn't it?
Yes, sir. You do Howie a favor, distribute all through our police station.
How long has that chef worked for you?
Zubin? Just month. Superior chef. Makes all kinds of new sushi.
What's real fresh tonight?
Special shipment of toro just arrived. I fix you right up. No one else. Clean as a whistle.
You're Prince, Howie. Howie says you're a master chef.
Do not come back here. Air bad.
This'll only take a minute. There's a test I'd like you to take. It won't take too long.
Test? What kind of test?
Kind of a personality test. Totally routine.
Routine?
A big guy run past here?
Hey, maybe spare some chinyin?
Sorry, pal. All I got are hundreds.
Hey, that'd work.
Hey, Pop.
Lightning Squad, Rep Unit, Battle of the Gemini.
I'd retired a war hero, someone who'd fought for the freedom of the off-world colonists. The poor guy kind of reminded me of one of those buffalo soldiers, blacks who had killed and died for America, yet weren't allowed to drink alongside whites. And maybe, just maybe, the photograph validated his own existence.
Chill it, man. Just took a wrong turn back there, that's all.
Take your business elsewhere.
An excellent idea.
Rumor has it you've been earning your stripes, McCoy.
Working on it.
Keep it up. You just might have a future in this business.
I understand it's got a hell of a retirement plan.
I checked with UN Air. Looks your rep swung that Moonbus massacre last month.
They ever find the Moonbus?
Disappeared into thin air. Brian thinks it crashed out in the Kipple.
How many reps we talking about?
Enough. They're Nexus Sixes. So don't take too much slack.
Gotcha.
You VK the mark before retirement?
Didn't have to.
That's why they call it the magic.
I'm starting to understand.
You ever retire a human, your career is over. Remember that.
See you later, Howie.
Number, please.
Roof. Apartments.
McCoy, 88F.
88. Thank you.
I lived with the best gal I'd ever seen. She was two now and full of life and love. She'd cost me about a year's salary, but she was worth it. It was good to have someone warm nearby after completing a dirty job, and the retirement swag from this case would go toward getting her a partner. Maggie, come here, girl. Here you go, baby. Dinner time. Here you go, baby. Dinner time. Zubin was the first Nexus 6 I'd come up against. There was something in his eyes, an almost primordial desire to live. Most of the 3s, 4s, and 5s I'd seen would just give up when they had them. But these 6s, they were a whole other breed.
I was angry with my friend. I told my wrath did end. I was angry with my foe. I told my wrath did grow.
Crank calls were a dime a dozen in this city, and I'd had my share. Still, this guy sounded more like an English teacher than the average scumbag. If I'd been more awake, the message might have spooked me.
Erase and reset. No messages. I'm in demand.
Violent street crime in the city rose again last year by a whopping 26%, according to the latest figures from the Department of Justice. Governor Kolvig attributed the change to the dramatic increase in the number of specials registered as city residents and promised a tough new set of standards for the City Immigration Bureau by next month.
Portrait of the Sleep Deprived.
Got your delivery here, man.
What?
Kingston Kitchen.
Oh, yes, right. Hold on.
Is this what the gravity be like on Mars?
Oh, no. It's about a third of what we got here on Terra. Real comfy. How about turning that dial, okay? When I say...
Please, can you control your rat?
I'll have you know that Ricky's a purebred chihuahua, and he's totally real.
Things going good at Tyrell Corporation?
Boring, boring. Old man Tyrell's been on a Wagner kick lately. He never shuts up.
You also do outside work?
Sweetie, I never go outside. It's bad for the glands.
How about Nexus 6? You know a lot about them?
I think you should be going now.
Understand good, it holds deep meaning for me now. Where be your research on Nexus 6? And your test studies, contacts, the works.
Only simulator! Extraterrestrial gravity!
One more minute, you be swallowing this explosive. 3 more minutes, they be hosing you off the True Life building across town.
No, I swear. I don't have anything. If I did, I'd give it to you.
My people sick and dying. You tell me something.
Talk to Dr. Tyrell.
Tell me something I don't know.
The organ designers, Miraji, Hannibal Chu, Luther and Lance, they're closer to him than I am.
Where?
DNA Row. They're all working down on DNA Row.
You one miserable package, man.
No! No, please, don't!
Pick up.
Hope you aren't camped out there with a bottle of tequila.
Oh, very funny.
Early bird slays the worm, McCoy.
Don't worry, I'm up, Lieutenant. What's the buzz?
One of Tyrell's employees got his fat face splattered all over the marble interior of the Tyrell building.
Inside?
That's right. But we also got a sweet little break on it. Tyrell's surveillance system recorded the whole shebang.
Beautiful. How many perps?
Just one. I don't know if it's related to the Runciter deal or not. Tyrell security will have the disc for you when you get there. You'll be good, killer.
Your floor number,
McCoy, LPD.
Just a minute.
Where do I go?
Grav test on the east wing, 66th floor. Here's the footage from the security cameras. You get a pretty good look at the man's face.
How'd he get past you guys?
He pretended to be a delivery man. Dr. Eisendoehler ordered in a lot, so it didn't seem unusual.
I may have more questions for you later on.
Yes, sir.
One more thing.
I've told you everything I know, Detective. I gotta work. These monitors don't watch themselves.
Yeah, it's a tough gig.
It was a Tyrell sales brochure for the Nexus series, the kind of glossy hype that ends up littering the floor at trade shows. This one was for the new entertainment model, a comedian designed to entertain the troops off-world. The earring was shaped like an insect. I didn't know much about jewelry, but it looked like junk to me, like the cheap crap sold at the stands and shops of Animoid Row. Someone had tried to access a bunch of protected files on the Tyrell network and failed. Not just once, but a dozen times. Tyrell engineers might forget their passwords, but what would the GravLab boys need with replicant DNA sequences and incept dates? I couldn't even begin to guess what Eisendahler's password was.
Jesus. I seen worse. But not by much.
Learn anything?
You could strain him through a sieve.
The dog collar has a name on it. Ricky, maybe? A takeout box from Kingston Kitchens.
I'd seen more dead animals than live ones in the last 24 hours, and now it was dogs. Three of them. I thought about Maggie and nearly threw up. Obviously, he'd been killed with an explosive, and not just because he'd been plastered on the wall with 1,000 strokes. The detonator wire I pulled out of his skull told the whole story. The killer was an expert. The charge had been big enough to do the job, but not big enough to shatter the soundproof walls of the float chamber. But I wondered why the killer didn't just shoot him.
Disgusting.
This earring yours?
Maybe it belongs to that other cop who was up here, the babe with the shades and the cigarettes.
Ain't her style. Call her babe to her face, you're liable to end up with a severe limp.
Eisendahler had used his dog's name as a password. The Tyrell brass wouldn't be too happy if they knew I was snagging a copy of their files, but someone had wanted them bad enough to kill Eisendahler, so I figured they must be worth having.
Lagging behind again?
Guza didn't say anything about me working with a partner.
Oh, in a pig's ass, Slim. No, I'm following up on my own. Could be it's linked to this Tyrell debacle.
How's yours connected to mine?
I'm still fitting the pieces together. You know the Moonbus massacre that went down last month?
Gaff mentioned something about it.
The rogue skin jobs probably flew to Earth. And one of them is a demolitions expert, similar MO to your Vic upstairs.
Hell of a coincidence.
I'll call you if I find out anything more about your case.
You friendly with Eisendahler?
Most of the employees I see coming in morning and night, but old Marcus, Dr. Eisendahler, he almost never left his lab.
He afraid of somebody?
I think it had something to do with the air outside, and the germs. I once heard him complain about it.
Smart. What was his job?
Grav test chief engineer. The lab runs tests to see how a replicant would perform in different planetary gravitational fields. That kind of thing. One of the other engineers could tell you more.
You know if anyone lost an earring like this one lately?
Not one of the employees, that's for sure. The boss enforces a strict dress code around here.
How did Eisendahler's moo-moo fit in?
Hey, you know, company rules only apply to the lesser mortals.
How do I get in to see the big boss?
You don't, unless he wants to see you.
Okay, how do I make him want to see me?
Well, you could call his personal assistant.
Who is?
Don't know, offhand.
Yeah, I get the picture. You know anything about Tyrell's computer system?
Security is tight as a drum, if that's what you're asking.
Somebody tried to access restricted data from the terminal in Dr. Eisendahler's office.
But they couldn't get in.
Yeah. Looks like Dr. Tyrell keeps his files safer than he keeps his employees. I may have more questions for you later on.
Yes, sir.
Lock up.
I got some more questions for you.
Your associate, Ms. Steele, has already taken my statement. I have nothing more to say unless I have an attorney present.
What do you know?
Zero that would interest you, Detective.
The goons over at the Tyrell building wouldn't let me talk to their boss. Maybe you can set up a meeting.
Anyone else in that whole company who knows anything?
You and I both know it's a one-man show over there.
I'll give it a try, kid. I'll have to pull some strings, so don't go in there half-assed. Make sure you got some legit questions for the resident genius.
Appreciate it, Lieutenant. Can the department float me some chin yen? This investigation's getting expensive.
Look, this ain't on the department tab, okay? This is a personal loan.
Thanks, Lieutenant.
This goddamn city don't know how to manage funds. They've been flush for years.
I thought we were under budget.
Trust me, ain't nobody getting rich unless they're sneaking some on the side. Hell, I can barely pay for the fuel for my car.
Ever hear of public transportation?
Get out of here before I throw my desk at you.
Bryant, go on permanent leave and you get full use of the office, Lieutenant?
You'd be amazed at how accommodating a man can be after his hemorrhoids get lanced. You really been surprising the troops around here, kid. Gaff says you worked at retirement like a champ.
Just doing the job.
Yeah, well, don't get too cocky. Those sixes can be damn unpredictable.
That I know.
But I'm proud of you, McCoy. Why don't you take the rest of the day off?
Thanks.
Payments is wiring the advance to your account as we speak.
How much?
Couple hundred chinyin. Enough to buy a sandwich or two. We gotta hold back the rest until the lab does the autopsy. Paperwork, you know. Shouldn't take more than a couple of days.
So, the check's in the mail?
Hey, don't worry. The boys upstairs want to keep our best and brightest happy. Any idea what you want to spend it on?
I was thinking maybe a companion for my animal at home.
Forget that. Buy yourself something nice. Once you start carving up that juicy bacon, kid, the taste never goes away. The great things in life, believe me, you'll just be wanting more and more.
Sorry to bother you, Lieutenant. I was just checking in.
We'll get back out there. Those reps ain't retiring themselves.
Yeah, suicidal targets would make my job a lot easier.
Everybody's got a job, kid. Get out of here before I throw my desk at you.
Hey.
You killed anyone yet?
Mainframe and shooting range.
The Tyrell Corporation today recalled the last four functioning entertainment model Nexus 5 replicants from off-world service. Dr. Eldon Tyrell, speaking at a shareholders meeting, denied allegations that the model was defective and possibly dangerous.
The simple fact is that the model wasn't performing its designated function. There was one isolated incident of violence a couple of years ago, but the individual unit in question was immediately retired from service. No, the problem is far from anything sinister. The entertainment model just isn't funny.
The debt, the earring, king. The dog. How long has that chef worked for you?
One of Tyrell's.
It was a
mostly
lightning squad.
Scanning video disc. One enhanceable image found. Adding enhanceable photographs to Kaya database. Tyrell Grav Test Lab.
A takeout box from Kingston Kitchens. Give me a hard copy of that.
The earring was shaped like an insect. I didn't know much about jewelry, but it looked like junk to me, like the cheap crap sold at the stands and shops of Animoid Row.
Give me a hard copy of that.
A bomb.
Give me a hard copy of that.
The dog collar has a name on it. Ricky, maybe?
Give me a hard copy of that.
The earring was shaped...
The dog collar has a name... Kingston Kitchens. Where have I heard...
Uploading personal clue database. Downloading mainframe clue database. Clue database transfer complete.
This is Crystal Steel, badge number BR61354. Still working the explosion at the Tyrell manufacturing plant. It'll take a day or so to analyze the debris, but there's no doubt in my mind that we're dealing with a bomber here. Right now, it looks like the protesters had nothing to do with it. They were in too close proximity to have been in on the deal. No MOs or identities are rolling up just yet, and I'm still going through the inset files to see if any replicant munitions experts are unaccounted for. This is Crystal Steel, badge number BR61354, conducting the interrogation of Spencer Gregorian, leader of CARS, Citizens Against Replicant Slavery, November 22nd, 2019.
I once again asked that my attorney...
Shut it, shitbird. I'm asking the questions. We've already put you on the machine, so we know you're not a skin job.
That term offends me.
Okay, so you're not one of those biomechanical scumbags. And you claim to not know anything about the bombing at Tyrell.
This is true. We advocate equal rights under the law for replicants. We have nothing against Tyrell Corporation for creating them.
That's some sick logic.
The replicants are living organisms, whether people like you like it or not. Replicants contribute greatly to the economic well-being of our culture. They cannot be discounted as such.
Hell, it'd be no skin off my nose if each and every one of them was hosed down for good. You ever see this guy?
Why, yes. Actually, I have. He was present at the protest. He's not part of our group, but outsiders are usually welcome.
How many new faces showed up that day?
Not too many. A handful at most.
Describe them to me.
I don't know if I can.
Oh no? Recording off. Describe them for me again.
There was that Rastafarian fellow, and one of our ex-members showed up.
Who's that?
A Japanese man named Izo.
Why'd you get rid of him?
We're a pacifist organization, and we have rules. One of them is no weapons allowed. Izo refused to check in a samurai sword at the door during meetings.
Where can I find this Izo?
He owns one of those little secondhand stores downtown.
Let me ask you a question. Who the hell bankrolls your operation?
We have a number of anonymous donors, people with resources and sources.
Such as?
So anonymous, even I don't know who they are.
I almost believe you.
Well, if it ain't Ray McCoy! Bryant finally letting you play with the big boys.
My clearance come through?
You bet. You bring your piece?
Don't leave home without it.
Steele's been running the maze every other day for 2 weeks. And the targets are getting a little roughed up.
I thought Guza was going to requisition some new ones.
I ain't seen him down here in a month. Guess he's been busy.
Poor guy. I bet he gets all tuckered out from pushing those papers around.
And don't sell him short, McCoy. Guza could be one tough hombre. I remember when we worked vice together. He poured acetone on two pimps that gave us some lip and lit a match. I'll tell ya, it looked like the goddamn 4th of July out there.
Peachy.
You keeping busy, pal?
Nah, the place has been pretty quiet the last couple of days.
We get a new weapons shipment?
Yeah, Guza requisitioned a couple of cases for the assault teams.
Let me guess. He's planning on taking out a small city.
Lieutenant's a big believer in overkill.
Like...
Laboratory. Roof.
You know who deals in insects down here?
You don't want insects? They're no good companion. But fish. Fish are good. I have every kind of fish for you. Blowfish, dorado, miniature sailfish. Very friendly.
No thanks. I got a dog at home.
Fish just as good as dog.
No, my dog is real.
Real? Oh, you must make lots of money.
Let's get back to insects. Official LPD business.
Down at end of Animal Row, you see big green sign? You try there. Good luck with dog, friend. Hope he stays healthy.
She. This your work?
Ah, the dragon.
Dragon?
See? Anosoptera, dragonfly late of the American South Swampland.
You sell jewelry with dragonflies?
Items like that, very special significance. Very rare, senor. A state item, and most likely part of large collection. Person must have plenty of money to obtain a collection.
More than I can afford.
You try Hawker Circle. Might want to trade for this. With luck, you may find.
If this is from a collection, I'm also looking for the other pieces.
I make you a deal. I found out where to get dragonfly jewelry. Then you buy a piece, right? For a special lady friend? You come back later.
I'll do that.
You take care, chasing the dragon. Handsome man like you has lady friend, of course.
All my girl cares about is food and love.
Oh, how romantic. What is this girl's name?
Maggie.
Ah, Maggie, senor. It's perfect, is it not?
It's kind of ugly, but you talk me into it. You hear anything yet about that dragonfly jewelry, like what I showed you before?
No, senor. My friend, he's asking for me. If you come back later, maybe I know something more.
Might I interest you in a snake, noble one?
Not today, thanks. You know anything about insects?
I regret that I do not, noble one, save that I feed them to my snakes.
You do what?
Artificial ones, of course. The safeguards in the design of my snakes would not allow them to swallow a real insect.
I assume that this insect is already extinct.
They all died after the war, yes.
So the fakes must be pretty expensive.
If bought in bulk, the price is acceptable. They do not need to eat them, of course, but the added realism is worth every penny. Have you ever seen such craftsmanship?
Right now I'm more interested in the insect.
Perhaps you should ask the Peruvian woman next door. She's an expert on such things. And we'll cut a wonderful deal to friends.
I need to ask you...
Certainly the LPD must have better things to do than to question a humble merchant over and over again about the same things. Why aren't you out arresting criminals like that disreputable Bob fellow?
Bob?
He owns the armament shop up the street. He's insane, number one, insane. He takes peculiar pleasure in agitating all the vendors around here. I cannot even go out for a shisko without worrying whether Bob is going to sabotage my snakes.
Thanks for your time.
That a 45 blaster under your coat, or you're just happy to be here?
You got good eyes.
They ought to be. They're the only organs of mine that survived the Phobos Wars intact.
Ray McCoy, Rep Detect.
Blade Runner, huh? How come I never heard of you?
I just got assigned.
Yeah, I'm kind of buddies with Davey Holden. How's he doing?
Word is he's gonna be okay.
That skin job must have been pretty damn quick getting by Davey like that. He's the best in the business.
He'll be back in the job soon. I hear you've been waving guns around on Animoid Row.
Who's been telling you that crap? That lying Egyptian snake oil salesman?
Hassan?
That's the one. I should have popped him when I had the chance. You want to know what really happened? I wanted to get my daughter a present for her birthday, right? I bought an iguana from that crook Hassan. And the damn thing ran out of juice just 2 days after I plucked down a shitload of chinyin. Son of a bitch wouldn't give me a refund. So I threatened to burn down his shop.
Sometimes you just gotta be philosophical about these things.
That's exactly what my wife says. I heard of you.
Is that right?
You ain't done much.
I just got assigned.
Guys like you get hurt real easy.
Meaning what, exactly?
It ain't like you're a real Blade Runner. Not like Steel or Gaff.
They get hurt sometimes, too. It's a dangerous business. You got any decent ammo for my piece?
You mean the good stuff. 'Cause I know them police-issue spitballs just don't cut it.
Not these days.
Yeah, I know how it is. If you want to drop a skin job, you need a little extra oomph. I got a few clips around here somewhere. If you got the chinyin for it.
Okay, let's have it. How'd you feel about taking a little test?
You mean the Void Kampf? You come into my shop and you want to VK me?
Relax, I just...
It's funny. You thinking I'm a rep. Set up the test. We'll see what's what around here.
Reaction time is a factor in this, so please pay attention. Where do you live?
Downtown, 4th Sector. Hey, this is great. Should I be sitting any special way?
Just relax. A man dressed in rags approaches you on the street and asks for money.
I tell him to get a job. Ain't he heard there's a labor shortage around here?
You're 7 years old. You manage to steal several marshmallows from the kitchen and sneak them back to your bedroom. You're caught and your father spanks you.
Good for him.
You rent a mountain cabin. On the wall, someone has hung old maps and Courier and Ives prints.
I'm not much for art.
A deer's head is mounted above the fireplace. A full stag with developed horns.
I'd burn it. Burn the whole damn place to the ground.
For your anniversary, your spouse gives you a real goldfish.
I want a hamster.
Well, it's a fish.
She better damn well get me what I want.
What do you think it's like to be a replicant?
Gary.
Really?
Hey, if every right-thinking citizen was out to waste my ass, yeah, I'd be scared.
You have a little boy. He shows you his butterfly collection, plus the killing jar.
I'd beat some sense into him, and then toss the collection.
Like my briefcase? Department issue. Baby hide. 100% genuine human baby hide.
That's supposed to scare me?
Not scare, just shock. Provoke a reaction.
I heard worse in the wars. Hell, I done worse.
You're crying. Why is that?
What kind of candy-ass question is that?
It's meant to provoke a reaction.
Reaction, huh? Well, I ain't crying. Next question.
You've been drafted into the army. During a boot camp hazing, you're bound, blindfolded, and forced to eat worms.
The poor little guys. That's the army for you. Chew you up and spit you out. You know what I mean?
You're at a restaurant with friends. One of them orders lobster. The chef drops the lobster into the tub of boiling water while you watch.
I kicked the crap out of the sicko.
Test terminated.
So that's it?
Yeah?
Since you didn't shoot me, I must have registered okay.
Yeah, it was touch and go there for a while.
Well, you know, I think about skin jobs all the time. Try to get into their heads. Maybe that's what the deal is.
Thanks for your time.
Step up, step up. Mama Isabella cooked you something special. Put a glow in your cheek.
McCoy, LPD. Mind if I ask you a couple of questions?
Questions? They always need answers.
This guy work for you?
No, but I wish he do. He be one fine-looking man.
You sure? Never seen him before.
I'd remembered him for sure.
You send a lot of deliveries over to Marcus Eisendollar at the Tyrell building?
Eisendollar. Oh, Eisendollar, yeah. Let me tell you, that man can't eat.
Send anything over lately?
No, sir. No deliveries to him no more. Not since last month. He be way behind on his bill.
Not for a month, eh?
At least. No more till him pay up.
You may have a little trouble collecting. He's dead. That stew's looking tasty.
Fix you right up. Only dirty chinion. It put a spring in your step, man. The ladies, they be loving you.
Thanks for your time. I got a couple of questions for you, Captain.
First one's on the house. The rest you pay for. You want chit-chat, you hire a hooker. This ain't no social club. Nice bracelet, tough guy. Who's Maggie, your mommy?
She's a dog.
So is my wife, but I sure as hell don't brag about it.
Pour me one.
Just one?
One, but one good one. Pour me one.
Just one?
One, but one good one. Got some new leads, Lieutenant.
Get lost. We both got work to do.
Hey.
You're horning into my action, rookie. Take a stroll.
Hey.
You're horning into my action, rookie. Take a stroll.
2 minutes. That's how much time I give every stranger that wanders in here off the street.
Sell a lot of stuff that way?
I don't encourage browsers. What impresses me are people who know what they want and are not afraid to pay for it.
What's the most expensive thing you got in here?
Value is a relative notion. What's significant to you might be meaningless to me.
And vice versa.
Everything here is guaranteed. The finest, most authentic anyone can get.
Let me tell you what I want, and maybe I'll impress you.
All my paperwork is in order.
Doesn't matter. I don't read anyhow. What's your name?
Ezo.
You move a lot of valuable goods through here? Valuable and exotic?
How exotic?
We're talking exceptionally fine jewelry in the shape of a dragonfly.
Ah, they were so majestic. I remember them from my childhood. And that was the last time I've seen them.
It's very important that I find out about this. Can you help me?
If I see something, and you can match whatever my collectors will pay, it's all yours.
Thanks a million. Ever consort with a group called CARS? C-A-R-S?
CARS. What is that?
Citizens Against Replicant Slavery.
I don't have time for such pursuits.
How about Spencer Gregorian?
The same goes for him, whoever he is.
Funny, because he described you to a T. Even down to that stupid little ponytail you got.
It's called a chomaki.
What would you say if I told you Gregorian named you as one of the people who was there when the Tyrell building blew up?
There's a mistake somewhere along the chain of communication.
So, you're denying all involvement?
I won't lie to you, Detective. There was a time in my life when I might have been involved with such an organization. I actually cared. But now, all I care about is my business. I am nothing but a humble salesman. Perhaps I can interest you in this camera. 100 years ago, it was a cherished item. Whole families sat for portraits.
I've seen plenty of photographs in my time.
Have you ever seen this?
Off-world rifles here and more. Grenades, explosives, modern rifles, even some police-issue restricted weaponry. Ezo wasn't some small-time fence, but a big-time arms dealer. The exact arms that renegade replicants would be looking for to survive in the big city.
Nothing else there.
I am not about to have all my hard work obliterated just because you stumbled into my shop, Detective. Westerners need guns and hardware. All I need is will.
Freeze, Yoshi!
Ezo.
Whatever. Been keeping yourself busy?
I'll be out of lockup within the hour.
Your little skin job friend's gonna take up a collection to bail you out, or you got it saved up?
Maybe I got friends in high places.
Yeah, and if my aunt had balls, she'd be my uncle. What are you doing here, Slim?
I was gonna ask you the same thing.
I've been tracking this boy for a week. He thinks he's pretty clever. He's a material witness in a case I'm working. In fact, your best buddy's a replicant, isn't he? The big guy with the dreadlocks. What's his name again?
Hallucinate often?
That's okay. You'll be giving him up to me soon enough. I can handle it from here, Slim. Why don't you go buy yourself a lollipop? Something else to suck on.
Very clever.
But I wasn't trying to be.
Thanks for your time. You hear anything yet about that dragonfly jewelry, like what I showed you before?
No, senor. My friend, he's asking for me. If you come back later, maybe I know something more.
Are you taking any drugs? Does this badge mean anything to you? I was fresh out of leads. Poking around Hawker's circle had been a waste of time. I had nothing to connect this Izo character to the Eisendahler murder. But if the replicants had done in one Tyrell scientist, maybe they'd go after another. And the subcontractors down on DNA Row didn't have Tyrell's security to protect them. Sorry to bother you, Lieutenant. I was just checking in.
We'll get back out there. Those reps ain't retiring themselves.
Yeah, suicidal targets would make my job a lot easier.
Everybody's got a job, kid.
Why aren't you out arresting criminals?
See?
There were off-world rifles.
China Bar.
That guy sure gets around. Give me a hard copy of that. Interesting. Give me a hard copy of that.
Hawker's Circle. Uploading personal clue database. Downloading mainframe clue database. Clue database transfer complete. Thank you.
Hey, pal.
What's shaking, baby? Haven't I seen you around these parts before?
Could be. I get around.
You ever get down to Nightclub Row, you ought to check out my act. I'm just warming up the room, but it's better than a kick in the pants, you dig?
What kind of stuff do you do?
What kind of... You kidding, baby? I do it all! I am the direct extension of Frankie, Sammy D, and Dino Martini.
Who?
Man, you really must be dozing in Squaresville if you're asking who the voice is. You know, old Blue Eyes. The chairman of the board? Sinatra, man.
The guy's been dead for 20 years.
Well, you're gonna remember the name Gordo Frizz just like old Blue Eyes. I ain't on the marquee of Early's just yet, but it's coming, I promise you.
You seen any suspicious-looking people around here?
Hell no. I mean, a lot of wackos cool their heels down here. But they're anything but suspicious.
Excuse me, pal.
What you do, huh?
Excuse me.
Deliveries to rare.
LPD, I got a couple of questions.
Talk, always talk. You wait, you no take up time. Busy.
Marcus Eisendollar is dead.
Okay, we talk. Quick, time. What you want?
You were close to Eisendollar?
Eisendollar? No time for him. No go to a lab. Eisendollar test off-world gravity to work important organs. Visual center, you see?
Marcus is dead.
To work hard all night, all day, no stop, no break, no OT.
Did you hear me?
Of course I hear you. You think I'm deaf? Your time more important, huh? Eisendollar dead. Mirage may be dead. You out chasing skirts.
Mirage?
You eat supper with Mirage every night, no fail. Sometimes Chinese, sometimes Indian, sometimes home cooked. Sometimes we go up and eat with twins.
Mirage didn't show. Did you call him?
I call. I knock. 10 minutes ago, door locked. No answer. Where you come from, huh?
What?
Nothing.
Tell me this.
Hey, wait. LPD, you there for something, huh? LPD? I'm very busy. Eyes won't wait for nothing.
Tell me this.
Hey, wait. LPD, you there for something, huh? LPD? I'm very busy. Eyes won't wait for nothing.
The vidphone was one of those old Zenith jobs, the last electronic tech that was still produced on this continent, in Mexico to be exact. No wonder the sucker was on the blink. I recognized the logo on the envelope. It was definitely Runciter's Animal Sales, but I didn't expect to find hundreds of chinion inside. I didn't know what it was for, but I'd bet the farm it wasn't on Runciter's books.
Hello, Luther. Hello, Zan. You have no new messages and one saved voice-only message. Would you like to hear the saved message again?
Absolutely.
Hello, it's J.F. Sebastian. I hope you guys are all right. I tried to talk to Dr. Terrell about your reinstatement, reemployment, but I haven't been able to get through to him yet. He's kind of angry, and you know what a cool customer he is. I don't know what happened between you guys, but I'm still trying. If you want to get together, I'm still at the Bradbury. I'll be here all night.
Message saved automatically. To delete, please state your deletion security number.
Not right now. Thanks.
The pleasure's all ours at Sino Bell.
What's going on? Who did this?
Help me, sir. Please, help me. It is going to blow. Run! Run!
Hold on. An ambulance will be coming.
You must warn the prince. Up there. Up the stairs.
The twins? Did they do this?
No. Tall man with dreadlocks. The bomber. And another with beard. Piercing eyes.
What did they want?
The DNA information. God forgive me. I told them about the twins.
Don't shoot. McCoy, Rep D-Tech, BR-61661.
What do you know about this?
Got a dead man here, victim of an explosion. His name is, was Miraji. He was able to give me a description of the two perps just before he bought the farm.
Yeah? They skin jobs? Or are you just in the right place at the wrong time?
I'm practically waxing their tails, officer. I'm that close. But I don't have a lot of time. You mind,
mopping up here? Just do me a favor and kick some rep ass, okay? It's high time someone got them illegals off the street.
Appreciate it.
This is 32 Sector 3 reporting a homicide. Possible act of terrorism.
You got a sheet or something we could cover them with?
Nah, nothing. Cold Cup boys have been dragging ass. What do you know about this?
Got a dead man here, victim of an explosion. His name is... He was able to get...
Yeah?
I'm practically wet, but I don't have a lot...
Mop it up. Just do me a favor. It's high time.
Appreciate it.
This is 32...
You're Spencer Gregorian, right?
No. I really think my lawyer should be here.
I got some more questions for you. Tell me about your protest at Tyrell's plant.
I already told that other detective everything. Under duress.
I want to know about the people who were there. The Rastafarian and the Asian guy with the sunglasses.
I didn't know the Rastafarian. The Asian fellow was one of our ex-members. Izo was his name.
How long did you know him for?
Let's see. I met him about 5 years ago. He seemed so smart and balanced. He really wanted to help the replicant people.
Then what?
He started associating with the more militant factions. I was astounded when I heard he was supplying weapons to some of them.
What kind of weapons?
Guns so new that even the police had hardly used them, I heard.
I got some more questions for you. Lot of people involved in your cause, Spencer?
Yes, sir, we're growing fast. As more and more people realize that replicants have cognitive and emotional legitimacy, the Citizens Against Replicant Slavery will spearhead the movement towards...
Save the pitch for someone who gives a shit.
We're peaceful people, Detective. We live by a code that men like you could never understand.
Try me.
2 centuries ago, humans were held in slavery. Brave souls formed an underground railroad.
So, you help replicants escape the city.
I'm talking figuratively, Detective.
Sure you are.
We're not children, Detective. We have resources. The world is changing. People are waking up to the injustices perpetrated by a sick society that you have helped.
A lot of them will wake up dead if reps are allowed to run amok on Terra, jerk. I'm gonna give you a little test.
The other detective, she already tested me earlier today.
Uh-huh, look, I gotta check out the equipment, and you're the only stiff around.
I object to this treatment. If you'll just call my lawyer, he'll take care.
Your lawyer would tell you I got the authority to VK the mayor if I want. And he'd have to smile and nod and kiss my butt until I cleared him. So sit down. Reaction time is a factor in this, so please pay attention. Where do you live?
Third sector, uptown.
Nice neighborhood?
Very. Is this going to take long?
Just keep your pants on, Spencer. A man dressed in rags approaches you on the street and asks for money.
I tried to help him, of course. Buy him dinner or take him to a shelter.
What's the most embarrassing thing that ever happened to you?
I'm not answering that.
You're going to die. It may be soon. Death. The grave. Rot.
You're enjoying this.
It may be soon. The readouts don't lie. You're scared. Don't worry. I won't tell anyone.
This conversation is over, Detective. I don't have to sit here and take abuse.
Test terminated.
You keeping busy, pal?
Please leave me alone. My migraine's acting up.
You look right at home in there, Izo.
I've been in much tighter spots than this, McCoy.
I'll bet, but this is only the beginning.
Hello, it's J.F. Sebastian.
Of course I hear you. You think I'm deaf?
I recognize the logo on the envelope.
No.
Uploading personal clue database. Downloading mainframe clue database. Clue database transfer complete.
You got any discs from that camera?
I just served drinks, pal. But if you're gonna sit there until I cough it up, well, here it is.
Thanks for your time. Thanks for your time. Locked. You hear anything yet about that dragonfly jewelry, like what I showed you before?
No, senor. My friend, he's asking for me. If you come back later, maybe I know something more.
your floor number, please?
McCoy, 88F.
88. Thank you. Scanning video disk. One enhanceable image found. Adding enhanceable photographs to Kaya database. China bar.
Guza?
Give me a hard copy of that. No messages. I'm in demand. Portrait of the Sleep Deprived.
Your floor number, please.
Beautiful, isn't it?
The owl or the view?
Both.
The view's amazing. The owl, well, artificial things never did that much for me.
It's a flawless replica. We used a real one as a model.
Owls are extinct. Who told you the model was real?
Dr. Terrell.
He's wrong, or lying. Check your Sydneys.
Eldon wouldn't make up something like that.
You're Tyrell's assistant?
Yes, I'm Rachel. Dr. Terrell is very busy. I'm fully familiar with all Terrell operations.
He does know I'm a cop, right? Blade Runner unit?
Dr. Terrell has already met with one Blade Runner today and has important business to attend to. Your department should coordinate its efforts better.
Yeah, but...
You may speak to me or you may leave. I can't offer you any other choices.
Fair enough. I wanted to ask about Marcus Eisendahler.
I can't tell you who killed him, if that's what you're asking.
We've already got a suspect. What I want to know is why the killer would be interested in replicant DNA information.
That's a stupid question.
Oh yeah? Why's that?
Your suspect is obviously a replicant. A very dangerous one.
I thought replicants were safe. More human than human. Isn't Dr. Tyrell pushing to make it legal to use rep labor to clean up the kipple?
Are we here to discuss corporate policy or Marcus Eisendeller's murder?
A little of both. You heard about the moon bus hijacking. Yeah, I guess you would have. 50 people dead.
You can't blame...
I'm surprised you aren't out doing spin control. The public gets nervous when your pets wander around the city without a leash.
Replicants aren't pets.
Right. Pets live longer and don't go around killing people.
There are safeguards in the design.
Yeah, I've seen the data. Implanted memories, a 4-year lifespan. I'd probably get a little crazy too, but I don't think I'd start killing people.
Wouldn't you?
As I explained to Mr. Deckard earlier, I've given the Nexus 6 model a past. I've given it the purity and innocence of childhood. And all the joy and despair that comes with a real existence. That's hardly a death sentence. That's life.
I thought you weren't meeting with any more Blade Runners today.
Well, I decided to make an exception. Mr., McCoy, isn't it? You do understand the need for the Nexus 6 to have an identity.
Not really. No. I do see why a replicant who has an identity would want to steal Eisendeller's files.
Please, enlighten me.
They want more life.
They're wasting their time.
They're gonna come for you, just like they came for Eisendeller.
I have nothing to fear from any of my children. I'd tell them all exactly what I told you. Have I given you what you came here for?
I'm not sure. Yeah, maybe.
Then if you'll excuse me, I have a stockholder meeting to attend.
What I want to know is
as I explained...
Mainframe and shooting range.
Uploading personal clue database. Downloading mainframe clue database. Clue database transfer complete.
You hear anything yet about that dragonfly jewelry, like what I showed you before?
No, senor. My friend, he's asking for me. If you come back later, maybe I know something more.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
That's impossible. Nothing even if I was gonna...
Not good time now. Come back later.
那个什么在海边多啊? 啊,你还在那里多啦,麻烦你来那里多啦。 哦,这么亮在啊。 那个Iris那真的大啦。
Listen to me.
Busy, busy. You not delivery man. You go away.
真的, distraction all day long. Never stop. Loud noises on the street. Beep, beep, boom, 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 boom. Always make me drop eyes.
That'd be dermo design burning to the ground.
Oh? What of Marazzi?
He didn't make it.
You leave now, okay? Very busy. Must work. Must work.
You mentioned twins.
Yes, yes. Luther and Lance. Siamese twins live about Miraji.
They're genetic designers?
Were. Till last month. Got the boot, shit can.
From who?
Big boss, who else? And if I tell you go ask them. I waste no more time. You think I nose around everybody's business, huh?
Miraji's some kind of DNA designer?
Yeah, subcontractor like me. He funny though, like old movies. Miraji master chef. Twins go crazy when he cooks.
Marcus Eisendollar is dead. You might consider knocking off work early.
What Nexus 6 want with me, huh? I just do eyes. Busy, busy. Must make deadline.
Hey, yeah. What's Sebastian been up to lately?
Sebastian? He do what always do, nervous system. Very important to Dr. Terrell.
Where do I find him?
He had old building down the alley. Bradbury Hotel, I think. You walk down the alley, you find it.
What about this Lance? What kind of guy is he?
Why, he like Luther, only different. Don't know which which.
That so?
One long hair, talk a lot, always make deal. Other more quiet, work much harder.
What kind of deals?
Sell this, sell that, no matter what weather. Like salesman. Very hard to take, no trust, no way.
Did Lance sell something to Runciter?
Who? Never heard of Runciter. No time for charades. Sound like this, sound like that, look like this.
Sorry to bother you.
It was some kind of freakish toy, half mechanical, half organic. Rep technology for sure, but no one was going to give me any retirement bonus for it. I couldn't tell who was winning and I didn't much care. Chess was a little slow for me. I didn't have time to stop for synthetic eggs. I remember tasting a real one back when I was a kid. It was like liquid sunshine. Damn tasty. More useless junk.
Resuming interrupted print job.
DNA research, incept dates, a lot of jargon, but I'd bet my spinner it was valuable to somebody.
Oh, you think he found us, man?
One of the design subcons must have talked. Unstable personalities, to say the least.
Told you we should have blown up the old block.
It would have created problems down the line.
We got problem now, man.
This one? He's not a problem. He's an opportunity. You're weak, my friend. I expected so much more from you.
I'm thinking our brother not hearing too good.
Oh, he hears us. Isn't that right, McCoy?
You ready to give up fruitless nightmare man? Come back to family?
He doesn't have a choice. He never did.
Let me kill him, man.
No.
We got no time to be patient. The girl, she's sick. She no gonna get no better.
That's where you're wrong, Sadiq. She will live.
Maybe. But this one, he got it coming bad.
Believe me, he's the least of our problems.
You're talking crazy. The hunter be dangerous.
A fool sees not the same tree a wise man sees.
I'm no fool, man.
You must have a little faith, my friend. Without contraries is no progression.
How can you trust any of their kind?
We have been manipulated by them, correct? Now they're going to see exactly what lies on the other side of the horizon.
How long have I been here, Lucy?
How do you know my name?
I saw your things at Runciter's. Did you feel bad when they killed those animals?
They were so pretty and sweet. I hoped Father wouldn't do it. But Mr. Runciter deserved retribution. That's what Father said.
Why?
'Cause he treated me bad, like I belonged to him.
I'm sorry.
Are you really the hunter, like Father says?
It's my job.
Why? What do you have against us?
Nothing, it's just the law.
Would you hurt me?
I promise you I won't.
Father will be back soon.
It felt and smelled like real cheese. Dairy products were choice contraband, scarce and mucho expensive. Selling them was a Class A felony. Hysteria Hall was an arcade down near Nightclub Row.
Nothing else there. Strange.
You let him in my room?
They had a warrant, mister. What was I supposed to do?
They took my pictures.
Couldn't stop them.
How about me? You think I'm easy to stop? Who the hell are you?
McCoy, LPD.
LPD, huh? Maybe you guys can return something to me.
How do you know we got it?
One of your own. Invaded my property. Bad haircut. Stupid coat. The other guy.
What other guy?
Go play dumb.
What about him?
Nothing. I just thought you were gonna arrest me, that's all.
I don't care about your little run-in with the manager, okay? I'm looking for a couple of replicants.
Can't help you there, friend.
Maybe the clerk can tell me who was renting that room back there. Why were you hassling him?
He let these creeps in my room. I'm a very private person.
What have they got against you?
Nothing, friend. I ain't done nothing.
We're all innocents, aren't we?
Damn straight. And I don't like people asking questions either.
Just help me out here a little more. You seen a big Rasta guy around here? Or a guy with a beard and dark eyes?
A Rasta? What's that?
He's got dreadlocks. Talks with an accent.
Oh. No, I ain't seen no one like that. Look, my mother's waiting for me. You stick around. Maybe the manager will come back.
I didn't know who was working this side of the pool, but whoever it was, they'd been pretty thorough going through the joint. I doubted if there was anything I could find that hadn't already been snagged and bagged. The car looked a lot like the one I'd been tracking. The driver had been smart enough to pull the license plate, but the vehicle identification number was still there. If I ran it through the mainframe back at the station, I could ID the owner. Holden's badge.
Any luck finding more of that dragonfly jewelry?
Oh, see, see. I was right. Piece you showed me was part of a collection. Bought for a nightclub in 4th Sector.
You know the name of the nightclub owner?
No, senor. But my friend, he says the man is not selling.
Thanks for your help. What happened to your scorpions?
So, new shipment next week, if you like one.
Someone bought all of them?
See, a beautiful lady.
A beautiful lady who needed 100 scorpions?
What people like to do with them, I do not ask. It's much better to mind my own business.
Gotcha. Is this scale from a fish?
Same as other one. Not fish. Snake scale.
What other one?
Other police show me scale from same snake. I send him to Abdul Hassan.
How could you tell I was police?
Both of you walking around look confused. Like you in wrong place.
It was the pig still. He said Pat doesn't have a mink coat. She's got a good Republican cloth coat. That's all.
You're wrong, sweetie. It was Herbert Hoover.
I'm sorry, but I was there.
Well, if anything, you were all of 3 years old back then.
I still remember it, like it was yesterday.
And he said fur coat, not mink. I saw it on the Discovery disc.
You guys still battling it out?
That's what keeps a marriage alive and kicking, Ray. What can we do you for?
The works.
Coming right up. You know anything about politics, Ray? Famous quotes, things like that?
I try not to.
How about the Checker speech?
Never heard of it.
Well, Hoover's Checker speech.
Nixon's Checker speech.
You're forgetting a lot, your old age.
Right behind you, lady.
You seen a girl around here, about 14, with pink hair? Maybe in the arcade.
I was 14 with pink hair once. A long time ago.
Don't think he means you.
Of course not. Not now. We work outside Hysteria Hall, don't we? Well, we must see 20, 30 girls a day with pink hair.
And every other color in the rainbow.
You know where I could score some cheese? Like this stuff?
Boy, don't flesh that around here.
He's the police, sweetie.
Besides, the kids today just as soon twist a knife in your backside as to ask Virginian for the tram home. Show that cheese around here, you become a marked man.
Who sells it?
Now, we aren't asking for any trouble, Ray.
I'm not working, Bunko. I just want some information.
That nutty broad who runs Kingston Kitchen. She's always bragging about her special ingredient.
That stew she makes, it always did taste a little gamey.
And she charges an arm and leg for it, too.
Be good, you two.
It's a killer, I kid you not. Only 35,000. Yeah, red, orange, blue, puke green, any color you want. Just give me 24 to hose the graffiti off. Just kidding. Ask for the man, Crazy Legs Larry. Toodaloo. Admiring that bishy cat, ain't you? I don't blame you. It's a classic ride in a deluxe sport package. It'll push 125 without so much as a shake. Of course, you gotta find the road for it.
That's always the problem.
Crazy Legs, Larry Hirsch. Pleased to meet you.
Ray McCoy.
You can call me Crazy, you can call me Larry. You can even call me Crazy Legs Larry. But don't call me if you don't think a hot set of wheels ain't necessary.
Okay.
The Bishi's exceptional. Mechanical as Pacific Rim flawless, as usual. But they also save some of the classic styling of the old GM days.
Looks like a piece of work.
Forget those fibroplast Filipino heaps everyone's driving around. This is real. Just feast your eyes on this. You see it? You see it? That's actual chrome, the real stuff. They saved a couple hundred sheets of Tijuana chrome from before the war. It's completely legal and everything. Beautiful, isn't it?
I don't think I've ever seen it before.
And you probably won't ever see it again unless you steal this puppy. And honestly, no. Frankly, I gotta tell you, it's got your name written all over it. Ray McCovey.
McCoy.
Give it, take a couple letters.
I'll have to think about it.
Don't think too long or too hard about it, Roy. It's liable to be gonzo by the time you come back.
Gotcha. I hope you got paperwork for all these vehicles.
Are we kids or what, Ray? You're talking to Crazy Legs Larry Hirsch here.
I take that as a yes.
You can take it any way you want. Just don't take it for a test drive in the fourth sector.
I hope you got paperwork for all...
You can take it any way you want.
That sucks. Locked.
Hey, Ray, how you doing?
Just fine, Crazy.
You've been thinking about the caddy, haven't you? I don't blame you. She keeps me up at night, too. And I ain't ever even lip-wrestled in the back seat. Which is definitely what's in the cards for a stud of your caliber.
Throw in a babe and maybe you got a deal.
No sweat, I'll have one over in a jiffy.
No, just kidding. Why'd they kill Runciter's animals?
I didn't want them to. But Father, he was so angry, and Sadiq said Mr. Runciter deserved it for treating me that way.
Who else was there that night?
It's so funny. I'm worth less than those animals.
Not the talkative type. How old are you?
Early. How's it hanging?
Dick's licking hard as a brick. How's yours, General?
Your man gave me a hard time out there.
Yeah, I like Hanoi, but I can't deny his sphincter's a little tight.
What's on tap tonight?
Classy shows all evening, General. You're going to be able to cut diamonds down there or your money back.
You buy some jewelry at an auction recently? Real old, elite stuff?
Who's asking? You ain't with robbery and homicide.
No, sir.
Nah, those pieces ain't hot. I got the papers to prove it. I picked them up at legitimate auction. Cost me nearly a pound of flesh, too.
You give this stuff to a girlfriend early?
You kidding? I ain't that stupid. No. I was letting one of my dancers use the stuff in her act. Kind of a tribute to the ancient swamp fans, you know what I mean?
Which dancer?
Hecula. She's going on in a few. She's one of my biggest earners, too. She ain't in any trouble now, is she?
Not yet.
Good. Wouldn't want to slaughter the goose that lays them golden eggs.
Hey, Early.
I'm working right now, General. Ask me later.
What's the green?
Neptune's Nip. I think you'll enjoy it, sir.
Hit me again. You pick the color.
Ah, 2 of 10, 10 of 2.
Why is it called that?
Let's just say, it's a love potion. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, yours truly, the ever-ebullient Early Q presents the wondrous, mysterious Hecuba, singing and performing the sacred Thanatos dance of the ancient swamp.
Look, but don't touch.
Haven't I seen you around here before?
That's strange. I didn't hear a knock.
I just wanted to say, wow, you were awe-inspiring.
Well, thank you very much, Mr...
McCoy. Ray McCoy.
Is there something I can do for you, Mr. McCoy?
That's such an unusual belt. Is it antique?
They say it's from the last century. Those little creatures have always been my favorites.
Dragonflies?
Yes. And the whole class that contains them.
Tell you the truth, I'm from the LPD. I'd like to ask you a few questions if I could.
Is this about early Q? Because I could tell you...
Did any other pieces come with the belt?
I'm sure I don't know what you mean.
You buy a vehicle lately? A black sedan?
I wasn't aware that was a crime.
Buying the car isn't. Using the car in an animal murder, well...
Animal murder? That's horrible. I haven't seen the car for 2 days. It was stolen the day after I bought it.
Is that right? Any reason you didn't tell me that right off?
You didn't ask.
Animal murder's pretty horrible.
Yes. Any murder is horrible. And unfortunate.
Some are worse than others.
But death's the same for all.
No argument there. There's a little test I'd like you to take.
Do you think I'm a replicant? Is that what this is about? If it's early Q, I'll help you any way you want.
Not exactly.
This is insane. I have a family, a daughter, for heaven's sake. Look, I'm willing to testify against early Q. A replicant wouldn't do that, would it?
A replicant doesn't necessarily care about what happens to another replicant.
Then you must be a replicant.
I'm sure I'm not.
How do you know you're not a replicant? Did you ever take that test yourself?
Sure I did. Long time ago.
Don't replicants go around with false memories? Maybe somewhere along the line you killed a human, took his place, and your superiors don't even know about it.
Interesting idea. But I'm still gonna give you the test. Reaction time is a factor in this, so please pay attention. Where do you live?
I don't see why you need to know that.
You return from work to find that your home has been burglarized.
The burglar would be very disappointed.
Out of the corner of your eye, you see a large black spider crawling up the wall.
Spiders frighten me. I'd call animal services and keep away from it until they arrived.
You're going to die. It may be soon. Death. The grave. Rot. It may be soon. The readouts don't lie. You're scared. Don't worry. I won't tell anyone.
Now I know you don't write these questions. You don't really expect an answer, do you?
Got one. Thanks. You see an oversized book with pictures of exotic animals on the cover. The title is Big Game Hunting in Zaire. Curious, you flip it open. There's a picture of a man standing with his foot on a dead Cape buffalo. You find yourself fascinated. You keep paging through it, seeing picture after picture of animals laid to waste, each more gruesome than the last.
That's not true. I'd burn the book.
You suddenly feel the urge to commit suicide.
Ridiculous. I wouldn't.
You're watching TV. Suddenly you notice a wasp crawling on your wrist.
I've never seen a wasp. I've heard they're lovely. I'd try to capture it. Then I'd call animal services and register it.
You're in a desert, walking along in the sand, when all of a sudden you look down and see a tortoise. It's crawling towards you. You reach down and flip the tortoise on its back. The tortoise lays on its back, its belly baking in the hot sun, beating its legs, trying to turn itself over.
Is this going anywhere?
But it can't. Not without your help. But you're not helping. Why is that?
You mean you don't know? You create these situations and expect a response.
You're suddenly very afraid. Why?
Do you mean what makes me afraid?
Answer the question.
I'm afraid of dying. And of spiders. Your questions. They're disturbing.
You're on a farm. You get into the pen to feed the pigs. In their excitement, the animals knock you down into the mud.
In this outfit?
Using a butcher knife, you slit the throat of the nearest sow. You're covered in blood as you stumble to your feet.
Well, that's a charming little scenario you've created. You make me sick.
I just read 'em. You're 7 years old. you managed to steal several marshmallows from the kitchen and sneak them back to your bedroom. You're caught, and your father spanks you.
I don't like marshmallows.
Pretend you do.
All right. My father wouldn't spank me, and I won't pretend that he did.
Positive result. Subject is replicant. Test terminated.
I get it. You're some kind of sexual deviant. I'm finished with you. Get me the police.
You're doing the right thing.
Yes, this is an emergency. Early cues backstage. A customer is harassing me. Thank you.
Put that away. I'm a cop.
Now we wait. If your hand moves, I'll shoot.
Okay.
Please don't talk. The sound of your voice grates on my nerves.
We waited there for a few minutes. Her gun in her eyes never wavered. Any other mark, I'd have been a dead man. But if she was a replicant, she must not have known it if she was willing to call the police.
This a troublemaker? Put your hands on top of your head.
That's right. Ray McCoy, Rep Detect, BR-61661.
Never heard of you.
I report to Lieutenant Guza. Call him.
I work for you? Let's go.
Where's your squad car?
Shut your mouth.
Which precinct are we going to?
I'll tell you which one.
This was no precinct house I'd ever been in, and I thought I'd been in them all. The grunt to my right had the beefy, harnessed bull look down pat, and his twitchy partner in the suit looked like he was just itching to chainsaw a couple of kneecaps. Other than that, everything was hunky-dory.
Impersonating a police officer, huh? I guess the new Nexus models are a little more creative than the old ones.
I'm a Blade Runner. You don't believe me? Call Lieutenant Guza.
There ain't no Guza in the LPD.
Unless I've been walking around in a dream, there is.
That's what always bugs me. Yeah, the fact that these skin jobs always gotta live someone else's life.
No shit.
Just make the call, dammit.
You're just a piece of shit rep with memory implants of this Guza guy, you understand?
That's impossible.
Rep ain't sounding so creative now.
You wanna avoid comp me? Be my guest.
Very good. Very good. Very convincing. Where you been hiding? The kipple? Gregorian bring you in? Who else is working that side of the pool these days?
I don't know what you're talking about!
What about that bastard selling all that stuff downtown?
Hey! Shut your trap. I'll tell you something, McCoy. I don't even care how you go out. But I know you can feel pain. And on that account, I'm your man, see? You tell me about everyone you met through cars, and I'll guarantee you we'll go real easy.
Your breath smells like you wiped your ass with your teeth.
You're gonna wish you was neck deep in an off-world reactor vessel by the time I get through with you. Fire up the chair, Holly. You know what I'm gonna come back as in my next life? A priest. There's something holy about it. How good I am at this.
Freeze! Don't even go for it!
You got any idea how glad I am to see
you? No time for chit-chat, Slim. You want to save your ass, we gotta blow this joint right now.
What the hell took you so long?
Good thing you made your entrance when you did.
Good thing one of my snitches saw them escort you out of the club. Otherwise, you'd be three quarters in the bag right now.
They must have been phony cops, hired by the reps for protection.
Cops, yes. Phony, no. I remembered Baker. He used to be an SID expert on coercive technique until he was fired from the force a couple years ago.
A mercenary?
Bingo.
He won't have to worry about getting paid no more.
That stripper you interviewed? She's one of them. Figure it out. She must have made the call to Baker and that other bozo. Let's attend to some business.
I'm there.
Nice crowd.
Regular folk steal, just like you and me.
Speak for yourself. You see it anywhere?
Not yet. You sure she's in here?
I'm gonna look backstage. Check the balcony and cover the exit. I don't want this one giving us the blow-off.
Jesus.
Been pretty busy, haven't you, Slim?
I think we can safely say that one's in biomechanical purgatory.
You had to clear out everything else up here, too.
Hope Early's got insurance.
Putz employs replicants, he ought to expect the worst. Oh, sorry I missed all the laughs.
Next time. It's around here somewhere.
Where'd you park it?
I'm telling you, it was right here. Damn thing must have been stolen.
Maybe you're living in an alternate reality, Slim.
Attention all units. All points bulletin has been issued for Ray McCoy, formerly BR-61661. Confirm one civilian kill. Ezo, considered armed and dangerous.
What the hell is that?
Maybe they just want to bring you in for questioning.
I didn't kill Ezo.
Maybe they think you're not what you think you are.
Are you saying I'm a rep? Come off it!
The look on your face after that last one? The minute you start to feel something for skin jobs, you're in big trouble.
Maybe I just got too much empathy.
In all the wrong places.
You want to put me on the machine?
Hey, I don't want anything, Slim. You're the one they want.
Detective Steele, BR-61354, report to headquarters immediately. Code blue.
What are you gonna do? Take me in?
No matter what they say, you're not on my list yet, Slim. You know what that means. And there's no use juicing you if I can't make some honest chinion off it, you know?
I never appreciated your baser instincts so much.
Guza must have messed up somehow. I'll check it out, see what's going on, and then we'll be meeting again, Slim. You can bank on it.
You got a deal.
And get cracking before I change my mind.
Good God!
Your old fogey stuff makes me want to spew.
Excuse me, but I was listening to music.
Geek!
Hoodlum!
Dork!
Freak!
There is someone at the door.
Speak.
I have a return package for Mr. Luther Lance.
A return? From where?
Emil Runciter.
Maybe one of the chimps blew a gasket and tried to bugger him.
They're not available. Come back later. I told you those strains were unstable. Runciter must have discovered the fakes.
Relax. Runciter's a simp. Not even old man Tyrell could have spotted those beauties.
20th century like a real drug, man.
Listen here.
Piss do you think you are? Blasting in here like a couple
no
of goddamn cowboys.
Gentlemen, take a moment to evaluate your situation.
Look, there's very little to steal here. If you can haul out one of the statues, be our guest.
We look like thieves to you, man?
No.
You look like a couple of goddamn...
Take a good long look.
Aha! Just the people we were hoping to see, right, Lance?
Huh?
Nexus 6! And you came to us.
Return to you, my brothers. To ask your help.
Unfortunately, we don't work for the Terrell Corporation anymore.
You've been continuing your research, I trust.
Yeah, of course.
Something drives us on.
The common bond. Can you have greater miracles than these? Brothers, my brothers, take a good, long look.
Oh, my God.
Well now, shall we begin?
You wake up one day and find it's all been a dream, or you wake up and discover you've been asleep all the time and the nightmare is real. I didn't know what it was. I didn't know who I was, a cop dangling on the short end of the stick, or a rep whose memory banks had run out. One thing I was sure of was that I didn't kill Izo. That I know I experienced. And this misinformation, maybe it was the key to everything that was happening. Maybe there was a lot more than what met my eye. All I had to do was stay alive long enough to find out. The tunnel stretched for miles. I was sure it came out somewhere, but I didn't have time to find out. I'd seen chairs like this one before. And not just in my recurring dental nightmares. It was an old-time LPD soothsayer, a torture device used to elicit confessions out of hardened criminals. Its use had been banned for 10 years now, but most cops knew it hadn't totally disappeared off the face of the earth.
Step off, mofo. Ain't no Maggie here.
She was here last night when I left.
You got the wrong place, Jack.
Hey, man, I live here.
I don't know what you're speed loading, and I really don't care.
Wait a minute.
I got no problem icing you if that's what you want, Jack.
Your floor number, please.
Thank you.
another one? Ain't you ever heard of private property?
Hey, haven't I seen you somewhere before?
Always chasing. That your name? Chaser? Got that big dumb locks out the back of the sushi bar, remember?
Small world, ain't it?
Guess so. And again, I ain't the one standing in your living room.
You said another one when I came down the elevator.
Not a lot of people. Artificials.
How'd you know they were replicants?
Are you kidding? I can spot a skin job at 100 paces in the dark.
Describe them to me.
Sure you don't got that drink?
Maybe later.
Well, there's the Japanese guy with the coat and the glasses.
Skinny guy, blonde hair, ponytail?
Yeah, and the guy with the muscles and the funny hair.
Dreadlocks?
Right, I've seen him twice. And the two-headed guy, the fat man.
Fat man? The one I was chasing from the sushi bar.
Nah, the other fat man, you know him, rough voice, always eating.
How many times have you seen the fat man down here?
Bunch of times. Last time weren't that long ago.
What was he doing?
Collecting guns like always.
Handguns? A blaster like mine?
Handguns, rifles, a whole armful. Took them through that gate. Dumped them in the sewer. Here, go on now. You sure you ain't got nothing to drink?
Can you describe him?
Yeah, rough guy. Barks out orders a lot. Everybody listen when he's around. A natural.
Let me ask you something.
Cooked it be. Damn tasty.
I'm talking to you here.
Bring me looking good.
No, we tried that already. Look, we know that the adenine thymine and guanine cytosine sequences can be mutated in progress. Let's move on.
Hey, it's about time you showed up.
You know who I am?
Detective Ray McCoy. You're investigating Meraji's death. And Eisendollers. Having any luck?
You're Luther and Lance?
Hell of a smart cookie there.
Take your guns and your violence elsewhere. We've got important work to do.
Clovis set me up, didn't he? And he used my boss to do it.
He's sharp, this one. No question.
Tell me what you know.
How about we trade? Our life for yours.
Keep talking.
Clovis has gone to see Eldon.
But he might not make it.
Still, the work will go on, with or without Clovis. Get us Terrell's files, the rest of the DNA data, and we'll help you.
You want me to break into the Tyrell building for you? You're nuts.
Defective, yes. Nuts, no. You need us, McCoy. We can serve up Goose's carcass on a big, oversized platter.
The reps that killed Marcus and Meraji, they'll be looking for you.
You're a little late, Detective. They've already found us.
So why are you still walking around?
Because we're all part of the same suit of cards, you know what I mean?
Eldon makes mistakes just like any other human. The difference is...
The difference is your bastard doesn't like to admit it. No, he covers them up, pretends they're human, gives them a job at a stinking corporation, and then when they actually produce original work, he boots them out on the street.
You're saying you're replicants?
We finally figured it out. Clovis helped us see the light.
But that's ridiculous. Tyrell wouldn't design something like you. He wants perfection.
I told you we were a mistake.
Keep talking.
Sometimes our memories are different from each other's. The implant process isn't perfect. We know, we've seen the studies. You can't always be sure exactly how the memories will play out in the subject's mind.
We've got different recollections of our childhood. Explain that.
Maybe one of you just forgot.
If you can't trust your own memories, what's left that makes you human?
What are you doing down here?
Eldon shafted us, so now we're returning the favor.
We promised Clovis we'd be finished with this by the time he got back, so if you don't mind...
Tyrell says the 4-year lifespan can't be extended.
Of course he's gonna say that, but he's wrong. Very wrong. We got the research right here that'll prove it.
Is it complete? Could you extend the life of a replicant right now?
Well, no. The 4-year limit is an integral part of every element of the replicant. Tyrell's dictate was that every body part would fail, and only the designers of each would know exactly how it worked.
Clovis has already unlocked the secret of the skin. That was Miraji.
Sebastian and Chu, they'd know about the central nervous system and the eyes. A lot of retrograde viruses were built into the eyes.
And Tyrell, he's got the basic DNA pattern information, but he won't just give it up.
Did you tell Clovis all this?
He didn't ask. He already knew. He knows all about you, too.
What kind of deal did you have going with Runciter?
Don't talk to me about it. That was Lance's stupid deal. We just wanted to make some extra cash on the side.
That probably had something to do with you guys getting fired.
I'm sure he wasn't too pleased.
Since Eldon's such a pain-in-the-ass control freak.
Did you meet Clovis through Runciter?
It was all just a coincidence.
Where's Clovis now?
Gone to have a little heart-to-heart with Eldon.
He'll kill Tyrell if he gets to him.
Isn't that just too bad?
I won't shed any tears. Tyrell is killing us all. 4 years isn't enough, is it?
If Clovis snaps his neck, it'll be merciful and quick. That's a hell of a lot more than we've been given.
I got a little test I want you to take.
You believe this clown? He wants to void Comfus.
Sorry, McCoy. Shoot us or leave us alone. Let's get back to work.
Stick around. I may not be finished with you. That sucks.
Hey, stop!
I think I got what you wanted from Tyrell's office.
Check it out, bro. The little man with the big gun did good.
A bargain's a bargain. You said you'd give me Guza.
It's all right here.
Your boss is a real piece of work, let me tell you. Almost as good as Tyrell. Take a look.
That probably had something to do with you guys getting fired.
Guza had his fingers in as many rancid pies as possible. He was insatiable. He sold police equipment, ripped off criminals, and he even killed. And here were documents that proved it all. Depositions, photographs, video discs. It was the complete file on Guza, the dirty cop. Where'd you get this?
From Clovis. He told us to hold it for him.
Come to think of it, I'm not sure you're supposed to see it. You want to give it back now?
Not a chance.
Let him have it. Clovis said he was finished with the policeman anyway.
A little light started to flicker in my brain. Guza was the one measuring me for the frame. When my stomach stopped churning, I realized I had everything I needed to force the bastard to play ball with me. I knew that he would listen to reason, if applied with serious pressure. All I needed to do was call him. Stick around. I may not be finished with you.
Been messing with people's lives lately?
McCoy, where the hell you been? We've been looking all over for you.
Yeah? Am I wanted dead or alive?
You don't know what you are, kid.
You can sell that replicant shit to everybody else, but I ain't buying.
If you're so clean, let's put you on the machine. That'll decide once and for all.
I'm through listening, Guza. Now it's your turn. I've been doing some investigating on my own. Came across some prime sources. You know what I'm talking about. Those little illegal weapons deals with Ezo. You were raking in the chinion selling LPD wares to scumbags and reps. Oh yeah, the department's gonna eat it up when they hear just how deep that corruption goes.
That's a load of crap.
Let's hope for your sake Bryant and the brass feel that way when I lay this file on them. Otherwise it's a one-way ticket to the off-world penal colony, fat man.
What do you want, McCoy?
Remove the frame, clear my name, and get that guy out of my apartment. I want my life back.
I can't do that.
You better start finding a way, because I got another call to make.
Okay, okay. How do we work this out? Can't talk over the damn phone.
The sewers. I know you want to be comfortable, and I figure it's kind of like your second home down there. At the bottom of the old elevator, there's a gate. Past it, there's a chamber. It's got a round platform.
Yeah, I know it.
Be there. Alone. You better hold up your end, or Bryant gets it all. That asshole out of my apartment.
It's cleaner than when you left it. My dog?
Yeah, yeah, your pooch is there too.
Is that everything I need to clear me?
I gotta tell you, kid, those insect photos look pretty real.
Let me guess, Clovis gave them to you.
It must seem pretty gullible, but he sounded on the level. He called you his brother, said you came down in the moon bus with all of them. He said Tyrell was using you to get inside the LPD. You hadn't been on the job too long, so I thought, maybe.
You'd screw with my head? How convenient. You could satisfy your blackmailer and keep me from sniffing around your dirty work at the same time.
You're too smart for me, kid. Water under the bridge. You ready to talk trade?
I got it all right here. Photos, files, discs, the works. It ain't a pretty sight.
You can't blame a guy for trying to better himself.
Trying is one thing. Ripping off speed loaders and selling the shit yourself? Farming out LPD weapons through black marketeers? Torching two pimps who wouldn't pay you off when you were working vice?
Hey, those two had it coming.
How long did you think it could last?
It finally reaches the point where you don't even think about what happened yesterday. Only what's coming to you tomorrow. 20 years in the job, kid, and nobody was gonna touch me.
Helping reps also part of the job?
I was gonna whack them myself once the heat was up. Tie up those loose ends.
Once I was out of the way.
Clovis is still gonna come gunning for me, kid. You and Chris gotta take him down. Then my problems are over. Our problems are over. And we can all live happily ever after.
I don't know. A lot has changed. I don't know what I want anymore.
That's fine, kid. Just walk away. I knew you didn't have the cojones.
Hey, I got you where I want you, don't I?
Kid, I'm what they call a survivor. I've crawled through the sickest sludge of hell and lived to tell the tale. I'll be around long after they've forgotten that you were ever on the job.
Wouldn't bet on it.
But I'm tired, kid. I'm ready to turn over a new leaf. I swear to you, everything will be different if we just stick together. Mop this thing up. Come on. What do you say?
I see we were right to follow him, Steve.
Looks that way, man.
You might as well give it up, Clovis. You and your people don't have a chance.
We stand a greater chance of success than you, Lieutenant.
McCoy and I were just talking about how to get you guys out of your jam. We came up with a plan. But you gotta show yourself first. We gotta do this in person.
And if I told you that Sadiq has a pulse rifle trained right at your heart?
Without me, you for sure ain't going nowhere.
Lieutenant, we have everything we need. And that doesn't include you.
Too bad. We're becoming such good friends.
Whatever is born of mortal birth must be consumed with the earth. To rise from generation free, then what have I to do with thee?
Kiss my ass!
So, what shall we do with this detective? He's been so persistent, so industrious.
You know what I would do.
Perhaps you're right. It's over. You're making me very unhappy, old friend.
Day, McCoy.
You could say that.
Steele is looking for you, and Bryant. You've been keeping the whole department hopping, you and Guza.
I know. You looking for me too, Gaff?
Looking, not killing. I'm in a good mood today. You know you got some interesting neighbors, McCoy.
Yeah, well, I've been too busy to visit lately.
You gonna turn yourself in?
I'm thinking about it.
Think hard. You killed anyone yet? It's like I said before. You retire a human, your career is over. Your life too, maybe. But we don't live forever, do we?
And so I say, well, you should have voted for him then.
Very good. Very funny, yes. Governor, let's get down to business. At last estimate, 5 billion tons of kipple surround this city. Eventually, it's going to have to be cleared away.
Elgin, we've got specials to do that job.
But the attrition rate is enormous. No, no. There's only one way it can be accomplished. My way.
Unfortunately, your way is illegal.
For the moment, yes. Laws can be changed, and if replicants were allowed to work on Earth, imagine what your legacy would be. Governor Maurice Kolvig, the national hero who eliminated toxic debris. Even your opponents will vote for you.
How can you possibly guarantee that no tragedies will occur?
It's a very simple solution to an old design challenge. Give them jobs on Earth, and they will never desire a different life.
That is a lie.
Who's there?
It's one of my children, I think, and a very resourceful one at that. Why don't you show yourself?
With pleasure.
Call security.
Who is this man?
I'd like to ask the same question.
One more word from him, and he'll be dead.
I will not be spoken to!
You're certainly a man of your word.
I want all the data you have on replicant DNA structures, the mutation studies, everything.
Why don't you just take a seat? We'll have a little talk.
I don't have time for talk.
I wish I could help you. I really do. But the data is useless. The 4-year lifespan is unalterable.
My friends, my family, dying before my very eyes, and all you can say is, there is no hope.
Time is precious, my son, and you have been keeping yours well.
And when night comes, I'll go to place fit for woe. Walking along the darkened valley with silent melancholy.
I would prefer him alive if possible.
Not exactly the conclusion I had in mind. Have you stationed guards in the mezzanine?
Yes, sir, but, I mean, after that fall...
Oh, don't be a fool. He's not dead yet. His time hasn't come.
Maggie! Come here, girl!
Pick up.
Where you been, Slim? The boys told me you were kicked hours ago.
My dog is still missing.
Cut the crap about the dog, okay? I got something that'll really rev your engine.
I'm all ears.
I got a line on where the skin jobs are hauling up.
Not the Yukon?
Yesterday's news. Remember Gaff was talking about that moon bus massacre? I found out where they crash landed it. If 5 will get you 10, they'll be licking their wounds there.
Excellent. Where do we go?
We. How about moi? Here's a hint, Slim. It's way the shit out there in the Kipple. Way, way out.
How are they getting into the city?
They've been accessing through an old sewer tunnel.
We gonna air out the reps together, or what?
I'm liking your style more and more. First come, first serve. I share my bonuses with nobody. See you on the other side, Slim.
Your floor number, please.
About time you got here.
If I was a Nexus 6, you'd be dead.
No, you'd be dead. I heard you stumbling around back there 10 minutes ago.
I got a little hung up. Where's the moon bus?
Real close. You ready to take care of business?
Hell yeah.
There's gonna be a hot time in the old town tonight. I don't like it. Smells like ambush territory.
Look out!
What?
There's a trigger there. See it? And what's that blinking?
Crafty little suckers.
Careful. Could be on a timer.
Looks like Sadiq's work. Same setup as the one at the Rep manufacturing plant. Step around it. We should clear it. All this Kipple gives me the heebie-jeebies. I need room to breathe.
You take a deep breath around here, you'll cough up a lung.
Maggie! Come here, girl, come on!
What's that tied around her?
Here you go, baby. Dinner time.
How could they?
Let's attend to some business.
Oh, God. No.
You like my present, Ma?
You bastard! She was an innocent!
She a big Ma. A machine, like you. Tyrell, you make her more doggy than dog, you know?
That's a lie!
You don't remember it, I'm thinking. None of it. Them false memories. They really worked you good.
Come on out and show yourself, you coward! Finishing this alone, Steele.
No chance.
The bastard killed my dog. He tried to convince me I wasn't human.
The job ain't about revenge, McCoy.
If it's the money you're worried about, you can have it. But I'm doing this one alone.
You're a stubborn son of a bitch. Look, I'll give you 2 minutes. That's all.
I've been expecting you.
They're all dead. You're the last one.
I wish I could just leave. Just power up this ship and fly away. But there's nowhere else to go. And no more time.
You want me to feel sorry for you. But after what you did to Maggie, no way.
And what about you, Ray McCoy? After what you did to my family, to my friends, do you not also seek forgiveness?
I don't need to.
I thought I could cheat my destiny. I should have cherished what little time I had instead of wasting even one precious minute on revenge. My hands are labored day and night, and comes never in my sight. My wife has no indulgence given except what comes to her from heaven. We eat little, we drink less. This earth breeds not our happiness. Another sun feeds our life streams. We are not warmed with thy beams. Thou measurest not the time to me, nor yet the space I do see. But my mind is not with thy light arrayed. Thy terrors shall not make me afraid.
What a waste.
Jesus, Slim. I must blew your brains out.
Do it. You just might be doing me a favor.
You finish him? I think he got a promotion coming. Not to mention all those retirement bonuses.
As long as I get something like 20 hours of sleep in the process. I'm going home, Steele. I'm finished.
Hey, Slim.
What?
You ever think of working with a partner?
I thought you only worked alone.
There's a first for everything.
I'll think about it.
I'm much better company than a dog, you know.